Hello, friends. Welcome to another episode of Engineering Today. And we have some really interesting updates on SpaceX. So let's start with the news, which is now a hot topic for all the space lovers. The Inspiration 4 mission. SpaceX continues to make progress on its Inspiration 4 mission, which is scheduled to launch around the end of this year. As per the recent update, billionaire tech entrepreneur Jared Isaacman has bought the seats of SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft, which will be launched on Inspiration 4 mission. On Monday, February 1st, SpaceX and Isaacman announced that he would act as the commander of the four-person Inspiration 4 mission. He's also donating the other three seats. As the name suggests, Inspiration 4 is designed to inspire the idea to reach for the stars and beyond. Also, this mission will help to raise money for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital in Memphis. This leading institution fights against cancer and other diseases and treats kids free of cost. It will be the first ever all-private crewed orbital mission in history, Musk stated in a teleconference on Monday. For this mission, SpaceX will use the Crew Dragon spacecraft called Resilience, which already flew on Crew 1 mission last year. As we know, Resilience is currently docked at the International Space Station. The spacecraft will return by the end of April or early May, bringing four Crew 1 astronauts to Earth. The 37-year-old Isaacman is the founder and chief executive of online payment processing company called Shift4 Payments. He's also an accomplished pilot, which makes him well-suited as the commander of this mission. In addition, Isaacman is currently working with his company and St. Jude Children's Research Hospital to select the other three crew members who will be on board with him in the Inspiration 4 mission. The three crew members we are selecting come from everyday walks of life, including a frontline healthcare worker who's committed to helping kids fight cancer, someone who visits our mission's website and makes a donation, and an inspiring entrepreneur building a business, he stated in a teleconference regarding the mission. 30 days from now, they're going to get fitted for a spacesuit. Isaacman also gave us a hint about the second passenger, that it will be someone from St. Jude Hospital, although he's not mentioned any name. I know she's looking forward to the launch as much as me, he stated. Inspiration 4 is the realization of a lifelong dream and a step towards a future in which anyone can venture out and explore the stars, Isaacman added. I appreciate the tremendous responsibility that comes with commanding this mission, and I want to use this historic moment to inspire humanity while helping to tackle childhood cancer here on Earth. According to the mission status, SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft will fly on top of a Falcon 9 rocket from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The spacecraft will spend 2 to 4 days in space, floating in low Earth orbit, then return to Earth for an ocean splashdown. While in space, the spacecraft will not dock with the International Space Station. While having two people already selected, including Isaacman, for Inspiration 4 mission, other two passengers will be selected from a raffle, which includes buying entries for $100 million on the Inspiration 4 website. And the other one is from a contest affiliated with Shift4 Payments. According to Isaacman, the winners will join him in a pretty extensive training plan to prepare for the mission and also to know each other before they spend some days in a spacecraft. I'm going to ensure that I introduce some very uncomfortable and stressful situations here on Earth long before we go up in space, he stated. I intend to get four people into a tent that I can attest is absolutely smaller than the Dragon spacecraft on a mountain when it's snowing out and introduce everyone to some really stressful situations. Isaacman already knows the medical requirements for this mission. The rule is passengers taller than 1.98 meters, heavier than 113.4 kilograms, physically and psychologically unfit, will not be allowed to fly. I've already gone through the SpaceX medical screening process, and I can tell you that the attitude is about how do you get someone into space and how not you ground them, Isaacman said. If you can go on a roller coaster ride, you should be fine for going on Dragon, Musk added. NASA is offering its full support for this mission. Kathy Luters, NASA's Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations, stated, "Excited to see one of the original goals of commercial crew come to be with the expansion of new commercial activities beyond our own in low Earth orbit." SpaceX CEO is also excited for this all-civilian spacecraft mission, as he said, "I'll be on a flight one day, but not this one." Now we'll talk about some recent updates of SpaceX's Super Heavy booster. All the SpaceX fans out there are eagerly waiting to see SpaceX's Super Heavy booster, which is said to be the world's tallest, heaviest rocket booster ever built. As per the recent update, SpaceX Starship program's first Super Heavy booster, known as Booster Number 1 or BN1, has been found. Those show that SpaceX is already halfway there to complete its massive Starship booster. Standing around 70 meters or approximately 230 feet tall from tip to tail, the vehicle is set to be the world's most powerful liquid rocket booster. The booster will have a diameter of 9 meters or 30 feet. Jack Beyer, an aerospace and launch photographer, posted a picture of SpaceX's Super Heavy booster. "Super Heavy booster number 1 construction continues in the high bay," he added with the picture. Now let's dive into some more details. A fully fueled Super Heavy booster weighs around 3,700 metric tons, capable of producing 7,500 metric tons or 16.5 million pound force of thrust during the liftoff. On the top of SpaceX's Super Heavy booster will have the reusable Starship, which is 40% shorter than the rocket booster is. Compared to the Super Heavy, SpaceX's Starship can produce a total thrust equivalent to Falcon 9's first stage. On the other hand, SpaceX's Super Heavy booster will be almost similar with 10 Falcon 9's full thrust. SpaceX Super Heavy booster atop the Starship will be even taller than SLS Block 2 cargo rocket. The basic design of Super Heavy is pretty much simple and similar with any other liquid-fueled rocket. The body of a Super Heavy rocket is made of a tall and thin Falcon-style cylinder, but without any exterior coating. Super Heavy's airframe is developed from joining two main propellant tanks together by a common dome. One end of the structure is made to attach the booster to the Starship, while the other end is the engine section, which finally encloses the thrust dome. As shown in many photos, SpaceX already half completed the Super Heavy construction. The booster currently stands 18 steel rings tall, which is most probably Super Heavy BN1's liquid oxygen tank. This 18 steel ring structure ensures that Super Heavy's LOX tank will be on the top of its methane fuel tank. With 38 or 39 rings stacked one after the other, the booster will reach half of its full height. According to SpaceX, Super Heavy booster BN1 will need to pass the initial cryogenic proof and static fire test in order to conduct the hop test. On the other hand, SpaceX is working on the BN2 prototype. Let's move to the last segment of our news. The Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, recently made an accusation against SpaceX over the Starship launch in December. According to the FAA, SpaceX has violated the conditions of a launch license during its Starship SN8 launch. On Tuesday, February 2nd, the Federal Aviation Administration said in its statement that SpaceX previously requested a waiver to its FAA license for its Starship flight test, where FAA said would have allowed SpaceX to exceed the maximum public risk allowed by federal safety regulations. Now, the FAA said they denied the request, but SpaceX still conducted the Starship launch. As we know, SpaceX successfully launched its Starship SN9 to a certain height, but unfortunately, the Starship exploded while landing. However, the explosion did not cause any injuries or third-party damage. Still, the FAA is making accusations against SpaceX about the violation of the conditions of its license. As a result of this non-compliance, the FAA required SpaceX to conduct an investigation of the incident, the FAA stated. All testing that could affect public safety at the Boca Chica, Texas launch site was suspended until the investigation was completed, and the FAA approved the company's corrective actions to protect public safety. According to the FAA, the waiver request involved public risk to far-field blast overpressure. The FAA also required SpaceX to conduct an investigation of the incident including a comprehensive review of the company's safety culture, operational decision-making, and process discipline. Jared Zambrano Stout, former Deputy Chief of Staff and Senior Advisor with the FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation, handles the license issues regarding these types of launches. He stated, "If a licensee violates the terms of their launch license, they did so knowing that an uninvolved member of the public could have been hurt or killed. That's not an exaggeration. They took a calculated risk with your life and property." At the end, the FAA's allegation against SpaceX does not completely make sense because SpaceX took all the safety measures during SN8 and SN9's launch. Moreover, no injuries were reported. Let's hope that it doesn't cause any problems for SpaceX in their upcoming Starship launches. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.